Hello there, all you amazing geeks and nerds and what have you not. I have been told that Valve is this amazing, great, open source, privacy-focused, don't take telemetry, don't do, or will it does, but it's not as bad as Microsoft. I'm doing a little bit of a shoot-off here. Let's look at Steam. In this case, it's Valve-owned. It's probably the product that most people use from the Valve company versus Microsoft. And so I'm going to look at what do Steam does when it comes to your data collection, stuff like that. I'm not going to read all of this, just take some high point out of it, but they have this massive document here explaining what they are doing with your data. So apparently they are taking some data. They are spying on you, so to speak. And then we are going we're not really going to compare that to Microsoft, because we all know what Microsoft do, what data they take, what telemetry they take. So this is just based to show what Israel doing. Again, we all know Microsoft is taking data and telemetry. Then we are going to look at what do Valve do for open source versus what do Microsoft do for open source. Let's go into it here a little bit. Other data and you explicitly submit. So they say basically here that, yeah, they do collect data. My Valve collects and process data. This is basically whole the section here. We will collect and process personal data whenever you explicitly provide it to us or send it as part of a communication with others on Steam. So if you're communicating with others on Steam, it could be publishers, friends and stuff like that, and you are using personal data, they can collect it. In Steam community forums, chats, and when you provide feedback to other users, guaranteed content or generate content, data includes information that you post, comments, or follow any of the content services, information sent through chat, blah, 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 blah. We collect a variety of information through your general interaction with the website. Content and services offered by Steam. Personal data we collect may include, but not limited to. This is really important to remember. May include, not limited to. It basically means they can do whatever the fuck they want. To browser and device information. Data collected through automatic electronics interactions and application use data. Another one I found here, of course, they use cookies, your use of games and other services. In order to provide you with the services, we need to collect, store, and use various information about your activity in our content and services, content-related information, including the Steam ID, as well as what is usually referred to as game statistics. By game statistics, we mean information about your game, preferences, processing game, playtime, and you get the idea here. Valve does not sell personal data, so they don't take money from your data. However, so this is like, we don't allow people to give us money so we can give you your data, but we kind of just freely share it with everyone, basically. We may share or provide access to each of those categories of personal data we collect as necessary for the following processes. Valve and its subsidiaries and blah, 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 blah. This is just Steam. We are not talking about the game themselves that also are probing you up your fucking ass and in your ear and in your mouth and taking your kidneys and stuff like that. Not to speak about what happens with all your games if Valve decide to say, you know what, fuck this Steam shit. We are closing the business, we are going to do other things. And another thing that a lot of people don't know is that if you're playing a AAA game, even a AA game, maybe just an A game, most games nowadays you are leasing and not owning. So if you are angry at Microsoft for not owning the software, you should not, at least not play any AAA games. Plus, they take way more data collection than Microsoft does and stuff like that. This data collection here, it's the same that Microsoft do. It's in the same nature of Microsoft. The only difference between Valve's, Steam, and Microsoft's Windows is that Microsoft is opt-out, Steam is opt-in. When I say opt-in, a lot of it is turned on by default, by the way, under Steam. How can you check this? Well, this is from February 2023. This is just a small amount. Operating system, RAM, Intel CPU speed, physical CPUs, video card description, RAM, primary display resolution, blah, 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 language, free hard disk space, total hard disk space. It's mind-boggling. I will say this, at least it's really fucking easy to find under Steam to see what, some of the data that they're using. I can't go in and see what they're doing with my personal data, but I can see what they're doing with my hardware telemetry. This is also what Windows does. They do it for the same sake of bug fixing, because most people don't submit bug reports. They really don't. I'm sorry to say it. Windows, Linux, Mac OS, blah, blah, blah. They don't submit bug reports. A lot of telemetry is to help them bug fix software. The telemetry is what happens with your system when a bug occurs, and that is being sent to them, and they use it. They also use it to analyze, okay, how big a percentage of our people are using X, Y, and Z resolution, X, Y, and Z RAM, X, Y, and Z, you know, hardware, basically. So they know how to cater their game / software to their biggest user base. It don't help that they, let's say, make a office suite that takes 8 gig of RAM if 90% is only using 4 gig. So they're basically, you know, forcing people to upgrade. It have happened in the past. Microsoft have done it. Linux have done it. I remember using Linux back in the day where you could run it on under a gigabyte of RAM stick. Now you need at least 2 to 4 gigs of RAM to have like a pleasant Linux experience. It's just the normal progression of software. It takes more and more resources. But you get what I'm coming at here. If you ask me, Valve is as bad, if not a little bit worse, than Microsoft when it comes to data collection. Because they can do with it what they want. Well, I would say they're on par. Let's be nice and say Valve is just as bad as Microsoft when it comes to data collection and personal data. I still hear a lot of people that think that Valve don't do any of this. Like, for real. They think that when they're buying a game on Steam, they are totally anonymous. They own every fucking thing. There's no data collection being taken, stuff like that. And again, I'm just talking Steam here. I'm not talking about Call of Duty, World of Warcraft, and all of the games that you may play that also takes even more statistics and telemetry out of you. So let's look at what Valve is doing for open source. So I'm going on to Valve's GitHub page there. They have 49 repositories. Not bad. Not bad. 94 repositories. 10 people and stuff like that. This is kind of a good representation of how big Valve is into open source. What else do they do? Valve is paying a whole lot of developers to keep the Steam Deck open source and software going. What is a whole lot? 5 people? 10 people? I couldn't really find a number in here. So a whole lot? What is a whole lot? I don't know the number a whole lot. Let's just say 100, even 1,000 people. I don't know. This is why I don't like, you know, I like these like a whole lot and stuff. I want numbers because my paranoid mind is that when they're saying stuff like this, this is a marketing spiel. This is, you know, making things look better than they are. Because if you didn't felt that the real number was bad or would make people look differently at the systems and stuff like that, or this whole article, you would just put in the number. Like, Valve is paying 10 to 100 people, you know, or 100 to 200 people, or 1,000 to 2,000 people. If you're using, like, a whole lot, that's so vague that you can bend the argument to fit your narrative. So they are trying to make a narrative instead of just providing data. That's what I read from this. Okay, let's look at Microsoft. Again, we all know what Microsoft do of data collection and the services and stuff like that. So let's go over to the open source. They have a dedicated site here with open source projects. I could not find one on Valve's or Steam's pages. May be there, just me could not find it. It may be there. And here they have their GitHub. So let's look at it here. 5.4k repositories, 72 projects, and they have 4.4k people helping them out. If we compare those numbers, I would say that Microsoft is probably doing more for open source. Granted, they are a bigger company, they have more employees, but they're also doing more with open source. But they are doing a lot more. So if we have to remember what Valve mostly are doing for open source and / Linux in this case is Proton. That's kind of the only trick they have up their sleeve. It's Proton. It's gaming and Proton. And as much as I love, I'm a hardcore gamer on computers. I just bought a new fucking graphic card. It's sitting over there. I can't wait to install it. Just picked it up. I'm a PC gamer, okay? I am a fucking hardcore PC gamer. But we are a dying race. More and more people going over to handheld devices, tablets, mobiles, consoles and stuff like that. And that's why Valve want the Steam Deck and the Steam Desk, or what it's called, their new console kind of thing that they're working on. Because they know that can see that even though that they are making more money than God could even dream of on Steam, on Windows, the statistics say that it's slowly going down, a slowly dying race where the handheld gaming market is exploding massively and Steam don't have a way to make money on handheld gaming. That's why they're doing the Steam Deck. They don't give a fuck about open source, anything else. They just do it so they can make money on a gaming market that is massively exploding and set to overtake PC gaming in the near future. But just looking at it today in 2023, and we're looking at just the GitHub repositories, well, Microsoft is way more active. They're having way more repositories. They're doing way more projects. They are doing way more for open source. But let's get further into it here. Funds. Oh, Microsoft is funding. The FOSS Fund provides 10,000 sponsorship to open source projects as selected by Microsoft employees. I have not seen anything like this from Valve. Making culture count for open source sustainability collaboration FOSS Fund 25. And here they are talking about, since the program launched nearly 2 years ago, 34 projects has been selected as determined by thousands of employees' vote. They are doing a lot. Microsoft grant Azure credits to open source projects of the year. So not only are they doing it in, you know, just in general, they're also doing it, you know, for their server platform. Tech giant pledged $30 million to boost open source software security. Microsoft and VMware pledged to collective $30 million to fund a 10-point plan to aim to boost the security of open source software. Designed by the Linux Foundation and an OpenSSF, the first of its kind initiative aimed to secure the production of open source software. Where's Valve with doing stuff like this? I think, was it Gnome that just got a big fucking paycheck from Microsoft? Yeah, Microsoft gave $10,000 to Gnome for being awesome, basically. Not only to talk about Microsoft, this part is on the Linux Foundation's board of directors, I think it's the Linux Foundation. And to be part of that, you have to spend a decently extra money, I think it's one time and then each year, to support the open source initiative and the Linux Foundation's initiative. Not seeing Valve doing anything there. So what I get from this here is that Valve and Microsoft on a data collective, privacy collective kind of aspect, they are neck and neck. They are just as fucking bad, okay? But who is doing more for the broader open source community? Who is actually stepping up and spending money, helping out with developers, talking with open source communities and so on and so on? Outside Proton with Valve, Microsoft is doing like 100 times more. And have been doing it way longer than Valve has. Valve, if you think about it, Valve need Proton for their Steam devices. You know, Steam Deck and Steam Box are what it's called. So therefore, Valve has an interest in keeping open source around Proton alive. So that's the only thing Valve does. They do the bare minimum to make sure they can make a shit ton of money on open source. They're not really giving anything back to the community. Microsoft is sponsoring Gnome. Microsoft have no incentive to sponsor Gnome. Microsoft have no incentive to give out grants left, right, and center to open source projects that have nothing to do with them as an operating system or on the server market or anything like that. The open source, the 30 million here that they are doing with security, yeah, a lot of people are using open source on Microsoft services, so it kind of makes sense. But giving grants and sponsoring, you know, projects, making developers available to help out projects, that's also something Valve have done that, but Microsoft is doing it way more than Valve do, of course, is way more than they need to do. So again, like the way I look at it, Valve do the absolute minimum that they need to do to make Valve a shit ton of money. Microsoft is doing what Microsoft needs to do to, of course, make them a shit ton of money, but they're going the extra miles. So not only are they only doing thing that is in Microsoft's own interest, they're also going out there and being a good citizen in the open source general community. So if you had two friends, one of them would only help you and do stuff for you if they got something out of it. The other one would help you if they got some out of it, but they would also help you if they didn't get something out of it. What friend do you probably like the most? The one that are going the extra mile and helping you out when they don't get something out of it. The one that are willing to sacrifice a little bit to be part of your friend circle and stuff like that. Where Valve is only showing up to the parties and stuff like that if they can fuck a girl or a guy, or it's beneficial for them to be seen with you at this party. If not, they will just say fuck you and go away and do their own thing. To me, that makes Valve a worse company than Microsoft. So if you're thinking that Valve is a better company than Microsoft when it comes to data collection and telemetry, you're wrong. It's just, they're just as bad. If you think Valve care more about open source, apparently not. They only care about open source when it comes to Proton. And why? Because Proton massively benefits Valve's bottom line. They now can sell games in an exploding market called handheld gaming devices. If that happens, that they can't do that anymore, they will do like what they have done with SteamOS in the past. They will shelf it. I've now shown you some data, and I know right now that there are still people that will say, fuck you, you're wrong, because Valve is doing some nice things that they care about for open source, aka gaming, making you able to play a lot of your favorite games on your Linux machines and open source machines. So a lot of people be like, well, I really like this thing and I don't want to go away, so I'm going to defend Valve. It's massively hypocritical. See you all later. Bye-bye.